Hello and welcome to the Conceptual Codon. Today we will discuss a very important topic from psychiatry, that is anorexia nervosa. Anorexia nervosa is one of the most common eating disorders, and it is most commonly seen in case of adolescent females. You have to remember that anorexia nervosa is a misnomer. The appetite of the patients of anorexia nervosa is usually normal. So there is no symptom of anorexia in anorexia nervosa. It is a misnomer. Now coming to the signs and symptoms of anorexia nervosa. The typical clinical feature in anorexia nervosa is disturbance of body image. The patient, despite being quite thin in reality, she perceives herself as a fat and obese person. It is rightly depicted here in the picture. The person is quite thin in reality, but as she perceives herself as a fat person, she is seeing herself in the mirror as a fat and obese person. So this is called disturbance of body image. It is a classical clinical feature in anorexia nervosa. The patients of anorexia nervosa is obsessed with fear of fatness, and they put excessive emphasis on thinness. So they restrict food intake, and restriction of energy intake or food intake results in a significantly less weight than normal. So the body mass index, the BMI of the patient, are usually low according to the normal. There are some medical symptoms that occur in patients of anorexia nervosa due to restriction of energy intake. They are hypothermia, dependent edema, bradycardia, etc. In case of females, amenorrhea is an important and prominent symptom. There will be appearance of neonatal hairs or lanugo. The adolescent patients often have poor sexual development. The patients of anorexia nervosa, the adults, have a low interest in sexual activity, and the adolescent patients have poor sexual development. But a similar eating disorder, that is bulimia nervosa, there the patients have normal sexual development. The patients of anorexia nervosa are preoccupied with the thoughts about food, and they spend a large amount of their time collecting recipes about various foods and cooking food for others. The patients of anorexia nervosa usually present a peculiar symptom, a peculiar behavior about foods. Like they would try to hide foods in house somewhere. They would try to dispose food in napkins, or they would try to cut the food into very small pieces by knife, and they would try to rearrange those food pieces in the plate repeatedly. So this is a classical feature in case of anorexia nervosa, fiddling with food, as it is depicted in this picture. Another important feature, the patients are usually secretive. They deny any symptoms of anorexia nervosa, and they refuse treatment for the disease as they deny the symptoms. This is again an important differentiating feature from bulimia nervosa. In case of bulimia nervosa, the patients don't deny the symptoms. There are two subtypes of anorexia nervosa, the restricting type and the binge eating or purging subtype. Restricting type is characterized by the highly restricted food intake, and it amounts to the 50% cases of anorexia nervosa. The other subtype is quite interesting. This is binge eating or purging subtype, and it amounts to 50% to 25% of the cases of anorexia nervosa. What happens in binge eating subtype is that the patient is on rigorous dieting, but the patient alternates the attempts at rigorous dieting with intermittent binging and purging episodes. This is like the cheat days that we do in dieting. So during the binging episodes, they consume a lot of food together. And there is an associated feeling of lack of self-control. The purging is a compensatory mechanism, wherein the patient tries to compensate for the excess food intake or the excess calorie intake by self-induced vomiting or laxative use or emetic use or diuretic use. The repeated self-induced vomiting episodes may cause some adverse effects like dental caries, parotitis, and hypokalemic alkalosis. This binge eating is also an important feature in case of bulimia nervosa. Before going to the treatment part of anorexia nervosa, let's revise the psychiatric traits and the metabolic traits of the disease. The psychiatric traits may include schizophrenia, neuroticism, anxiety, depression, and OCD, that is obsessive compulsive disorder. And metabolic traits include BMI will be lesser as there is restriction of food intake and rigorous dieting. The fat mass will be lower, physical activity will be higher, and insulin level will be lower. Treatment of anorexia nervosa. The patients may need to be hospitalized to restore the nutritional status and manage the complications like dehydration or electrolyte imbalances. The patient may need prolonged hospitalization if the weight for height is less than 20% of normal, and may need prolonged psychiatric hospitalization if the weight for height is less than 30% of normal. Other treatment options include combination of behavioral management, like they are taught to praise for healthy eating habits and restriction of self-induced vomiting. Individual psychotherapy and family education can also be done. There are some medications that have been tried in case of anorexia nervosa, like tricyclic antidepressants and selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors like SSRIs. Cyproheptadine is a histamine inhibitor, antihistaminics. It is used in case of anorexia nervosa. It induces weight gain, and it was found to be helpful in some patients of anorexia nervosa to gain weight. Now, lastly, let's see the differences of bulimia nervosa from anorexia nervosa. Bulimia nervosa is another common eating disorder where the patient does a binging episode and a self-induced vomiting, that is the purging episode. But the differences are, in bulimia nervosa, the weight of the patient is usually normal, where in case of anorexia nervosa, the weight is below normal and the BMI is lesser. In case of bulimia nervosa, as mentioned earlier, the patients have normal sexual functioning and the patients are not secretive about their symptoms. They do not deny their symptoms. So that concludes our today's topic of anorexia nervosa and its differences from bulimia nervosa. You can find the notes of this topic from our Facebook page and website. Both the links are given in the description. If you found the video helpful, do like, share, and don't forget to subscribe for more conceptual videos like this.